If you're using Google Tag Manager to add Google Analytics to your website, then your GA4 configuration tag is changing to a Google tag. This will happen automatically in your Google Tag Manager container. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a look. At the top of this container, we can see an alert that says, "Coming soon, your Google Analytics GA4 configuration tags will change to Google tags." This means we're not using the Google tag yet. Our container is still using the GA4 configuration tag, but it will be automatically changed to a Google tag soon. Let's navigate to Tags to check this. Looking at the Google Analytics page view tag, we can see in the Type column it says GA4 configuration. This confirms our container isn't using the new Google tag yet, so we'll need to wait. Again, if you see the coming soon message at the top of your container, you don't need to do anything. You can keep using your existing GA4 configuration tag until it's automatically changed over to the Google tag in GTM. Now we're going to look at a container that has the new Google tag. Let's head back to GTM. I'm going to open another GTM container. We can see at the top the message says, "The Google tag is now compatible with Google Tag Manager." This means our container has been automatically changed to use the Google tag. Let's navigate to Tags to take a look. We can see the Google Analytics page view tag says Google tag in the Type column. Let's open the tag to take a look. For this Google tag, we can see the Tag ID field is using the Measurement ID from our GA4 property. So this will continue to send data to Google Analytics, and you don't need to adjust anything once your GA4 configuration tag is automatically changed to the Google tag. Okay, so you're probably wondering, why is Google changing the GA4 configuration tag to the Google tag anyway? Well, it provides three benefits. Let's take a look at Google's announcement to run through these. First up, Google says that we'll be able to use a single Google tag to send data to multiple destinations. Currently, there isn't much information on this feature, and we can already connect an existing Google tag to multiple Google platforms, so I'm interested to see if there are any additional announcements about this in the coming days and weeks. The other changes are the new configuration settings variable and events settings variable that can be used with the Google tag and GA4 event tags. This means you can reuse settings across multiple tags. Previously, you'd need to create parameters for each GA4 configuration and GA4 event tag in GTM. Let's take a look at the new configuration settings variable and the event settings variable. To do this, let's head back to GTM. We're still looking at the Google tag in the container, so let's select Tag Configuration. We can see there are three sections below the tag ID. These are Configuration Settings, Shared Event Settings, and Advanced Settings. Before we look at these, let's start by adjusting the tag ID so that it's a variable. I recommend you consider doing this so that you can easily reuse the GA4 measurement ID across multiple tags. To do this, let's cut the measurement ID. Now let's click the variable icon. And let's click the plus sign on the top right corner. Let's name our variable GA4 measurement ID. Now let's select variable configuration and choose constant. Now let's paste our measurement ID and save the variable. This means we can now easily reuse our measurement ID, and if we ever need to edit it, we can edit it once, instead of having to edit it in each tag. Okay, now let's select configuration settings. The new configuration settings variable lets you apply settings to multiple tags. Selecting new variable using the drop-down lets you create a new configuration settings variable. There are a range of parameters you can use when you create a configuration settings variable. For example, if you wanted to adjust the URLs of your pages so they're reported differently in Google Analytics, you could create the variable and then adjust the page location parameter. I'm not going to create a configuration settings variable, so let's close this. The next option is shared event settings. Let's select this. We can then create a new event settings variable. Let's name this variable GA4 event settings. I previously created a variable that identifies the sections of my website, so let's add a parameter to our event settings variable. Let's enter content underscore group as the event parameter. And let's select my content group variable as the value. This is just one example. Apart from predefined parameters, you can also configure custom parameters to use as custom dimensions and metrics in Google Analytics. When you're ready, you can save the variable. This means whenever we adjust this variable, the changes will be applied to all of the tags that use it in GTM. Now we can save the tag. Then I recommend previewing your changes, and then when you're ready, you can publish your changes in GTM. If you're not seeing the Google tag available in your GTM container, it's because the change is still being rolled out by Google. Since your existing GA4 configuration tags will be updated automatically, you don't need to worry. This change will probably become available in your container over the coming days. Just keep an eye out for it when you log into GTM. If you found this video helpful and you'd like to know when I release more videos covering GTM and GA4, please take a moment to subscribe. You'll be notified whenever I release new tutorials. And to learn even more, check out my courses. I've included a link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.